House of Fatima. In this short video, I'll be speaking about Hasan ibn Ali, may Allah be pleased with him. He was the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, and was the grandson of the Prophet, peace be upon him. According to some narrations, there was none who resembled the Prophet, peace be upon him, more than Hasan ibn Ali, may Allah be pleased with him. He had a number of wives and children. Among them was a son called Abu Bakr, which is the name of the first Caliph of Islam, Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. When he was younger, the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned that he would be a sayyid, and he would reconcile between two communities of Muslims. The words of the Prophet, peace be upon him, were true, and Hasan, may Allah be pleased with him, did in fact become a leader later. That was after his father, Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, who was the first rightly guided caliph, had been assassinated. Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, never actually chose a successor after him, as he wanted the people to decide, and the people chose Hasan, may Allah be pleased with him. Throughout that time, there were also a few people who tried to kill Hasan, may Allah be pleased with him. He was a just leader, and he dealt well with the people. Although he was a powerful and successful leader, he did in fact manage to reconcile with Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with him. So he officially stepped down and handed over power to him. That did in fact end the conflict that was occurring in that region for many years. Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with him, was also a very successful leader, and he managed to found the Umayyad Empire. For further details on that, please watch my other videos about the Umayyad Empire. The events that took place also conform with what the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned, that the Caliphate would be for 30 years and then afterwards there would be kings. In the end, Hasan, may Allah be pleased with him, had been poisoned, which led to his death. He never actually gave the name of the person who poisoned him, and there's no clear evidence to say who actually did that, so it remains a mystery. Hasan, may Allah be pleased with him, is buried at Jannat al-Baqi in the city of Medina. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video informative. Please like and share this video and subscribe to my channel.